Hello everyone, we are
Jara
and John, and we're dedicated to making the world more accessible for everyone. If you want to know more about our story, check out our channel intro video. But in this video, we're going to show you how to set up the Microsoft Adaptive Accessories for Switch access on an Android tablet. Jara has a Galaxy Tab A8 that she likes to use browsing the web, watching videos, and playing games. But how can you control that tablet with a joystick and a hub? Let's show you. First, we need to configure the joystick on a Windows laptop using the Microsoft Accessory Center app. Now, what we want to do is assign numbers 1 to 8 to each of the 8 digital inputs on the joystick. Then I select the first digital input. I click on key combination and press the number 1 on my keyboard. I repeat this for all 8 digital inputs, going from 1 to 8. Alright, now that we've done that, let's move on to Jara's Android tablet. We need to pair the hub with the tablet via Bluetooth. Now here's a cool trick. I can use Bluetooth Profile 2 on the hub, so that Jara can still switch between using it with her laptop and using it with the tablet. So I turn on Bluetooth on the tablet and I see the hub appear. I tap to connect to it. Now when using Switch access on an Android tablet, we need to have the on-screen keyboard on. We can find it in the settings under language and keyboard. Also be aware that pattern lock can't be used with universal switch, so use a different lock type. After that we go to settings, accessibility, interaction and dexterity, and select universal switch. We toggle universal switch on and select add switch. We select accessories and bring in our joystick. We press the bottom joystick input to assign the first action to it and name it accordingly. In this case, select item, as that is required. We then go and add another action. Select accessories again and now press the right joystick input to assign the move to next item action to it. And we continue like that to add a move to previous item and name it accordingly. And we add an action to go back next. The nice thing is you can add a total of 8 actions to a single adaptive button. And it's obviously up to you to decide which input represents which action on the device you're using. That's it. We have set up Switch access on Jara's Android tablet using a joystick and a hub, where many people that likely benefit from Switch access would prefer to use a joystick or D-pad topper. I'm going to replace it with this larger 3D printed topper that works better for Jara. I will stick it down with some double-sided tape here. And if you need to learn more about 3D printed toppers, make sure to check out our Microsoft Adaptive Accessories video that covers its basics. Jara, do you want to give that a try?
Yes!
Awesome. See Jara pressing the right button to make her way to the YouTube icon there. This is the first time her ever using Universal Switch, and although her dexterity allows her to use a touch display, it can get tricky for her at times. So we're looking at possibly combining the two in the future. Jara is only using the move to next or previous item and select item actions in this clip. But any universal switch commands can be used, of course, like back, home, recents, volume control, scrolling, etc. We hope you found this video helpful and fun. Stay tuned for more videos where we will show you how to use different devices with the Microsoft Adaptive Accessories.
Bye.
Bye.